The Whiskey Culture Podcast is brought to you by Granddaddy Mims Distilling Company, making historic Tennessee moonshine in beautiful Blairsville, Georgia. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of the Whiskey Culture Podcast, your wide window into the world of whiskey, brought to you by Granddaddy Mims. Thank you so much for having us. We are here in Mystic Mountain Distillery in Colorado, and you know, we have just had a great time here. The whiskey and spirits are just excellent. But one of the things that really stood out to us was the do-it-yourself approach, that work ethic that you all have. And I think it's something that it's not just unique to some of these distilleries and the amount of tenacity and passion that you put in, but also just how people in general can learn from that. Like, not just owning a distillery, but it's applicable to us just as a life lesson, which I think is really cool. Tell us a little bit about the early days of the distillery.
Well, I'll tell you, it was a lot of work. It's pretty hard to get to where we're at, especially with the amount of quality distilleries around Colorado. I mean, you know, it's the amount of quality distilleries. The competition here is very, very fierce. We're all friends, but it's very fierce. So it was either kind of fall in line with everybody else or try to outwork them. And that's kind of been our approach. And that's kind of our DNA anyway. It's nothing against anybody else. It's just who we are. And, you know, we do 7 days a week. It's not a hobby to us. We are here to do something special. And the way that we do that is through hard work. Everything that we've had to go through, we've learned on our own. And it's just, we made a lot of mistakes through the way, I can tell you that. But we've learned from them, and in the end, it's always turned out better than when we started.
So, I mean, there seems to be a lot of passion here, because to do it yourself, I mean, that's crazy in terms of how difficult it is when you can just bring people in. I mean, from the bar itself, you guys made it to the table that we're sitting at. I mean, everything that you didn't literally need legally a contractor for, you guys did yourself. And that's, you're making it, I mean, it is a combination of more difficult for yourself, but also in addition to more difficult for yourself, there's a lot of creative control that comes with that. And it allows you to make the distillery a reflection of yourself. Was that kind of the ideology when you went in?
Yes and no. I would be lying to say that there was some financial pieces to that as well.
Fair enough.
But in turn, I'm glad it went this way. It, through a lot of the heartache, the long nights, the long days, you know, everybody makes that joke about build character. But I do really feel that you can see that and feel that when you meet with us and you hang out and you see, you come here, experience what we offer here, whether it's here or at events or just at a tasting. So yeah, it's one of those things. We just, that's our shield. I mean, that's who we are.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's it. I guess that identity is just kind of the core of Mystic Mountain.
It definitely is. Yep. We try to bring the blue collar approach to everything, because that's our DNA. I mean, you know, we're not the smartest group in the world, but sometimes, you know, it's like that joke, you know, if you're going to be dumb, you better be tough type of thing.
Yeah.
Not saying we're dumb, but I'm just, you know.
Well, what if you're like me and you're not smart and you're not tough?
I'll pray for you. Okay.
But yeah, I mean, it's interesting how the core of this, you know, it's about identity, it's tenacity, but it's about the approach of doing what you guys needed to do to get to where you're at and build what you needed to build.
Well, and also one thing that we haven't discussed either is we also self-distribute here in Colorado.
Oh, that's right.
And right now we have on the books just about 1,000 liquor stores that we sell to. And I'll tell you what, yeah, that'll tell you who you are. The logistics of trying to do distribution and stuff like that. Just not only just having to deal with the incoming, you know, supply chain issues, but then dealing with your delivery people, and you know, sometimes we have to do it ourselves. You know, myself and my partners included. But you know, you just got to get it done. But our approach is Colorado's our home, and we want control of our home. And I have nothing against distributors, you know, might be something we have to discuss later, but it's hard to give the keys away to the castle, so to speak.
Totally understood.
So we our main approach is to make ourselves big enough to where somebody wanted us rather than us going and asking if they would distribute for us.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think that, again, it lends itself to the whole mystique of Mystic Mountain, you know, is the keeping your identity, keeping the control of that and being able to meet people on your level. Because I assume you're going out to your accounts.
Yeah.
And you're being your authentic selves. You're promoting the brand and in the image that you've built it. And so, you know, distributorship, they don't always do that. And by don't always do that, I mean they almost never do that. You know, they're going with a portfolio of products. But this allows you to go and talk about all of these things that we've discussed and get these accounts to understand who you are and why to bring in the spirit. Not just because it's good.
Yeah.
But because they are truly supporting a do-it-yourself, pull yourselves up by your own bootstraps, Colorado true distillery.
Exactly. I mean, there's just so many brands out there. So if somebody wants to try something that's off of what their normal, you know, we're all creatures of habit. So if you find something that you like, you're pretty much just going to go to the store, you're going to get it, you're going to go home. But sometimes you want to try something different. So why would you want to try mine versus somebody else?
Yeah.
Well, there's a 100 other quality brands out there, even local ones. So what would set me apart from somebody else? What if I met you? Then you're like, hey, I met that guy. I know this, or I've seen this. Let's try that.
Yeah.
It's worked for us so far.
Yeah. I mean, and I think that's perfect. It's because, again, I think one of the things that a lot of brands struggle with is a lot of these brands struggle with seeing getting their name, their brand, what they're about out there, and brand recognition and people being able to articulate about those brands are something that a lot of brands struggle with. But your approach to actually go out and meet everybody, you know, we talked about that a little bit earlier, the grassroots approach, you going out there and meeting everybody where they're at and sharing about your distillery almost, you know, in an evangelical style and getting out there and preaching the gospel of Mystic Mountain. You know, it seems to kind of cut the head off of that snake immediately.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it does. And then, you know, and then you relate to your customers too.
Yeah. And you're out there and you're able to meet them on their terms.
Yeah.
And you're able to see like what their, you know, you're able to see what they need and what they want and hear back from the customers right at the very beginning of everything.
And it's, the best part about it is our spirits aren't for everyone, just like anything else, right?
Yeah.
But I like to talk to the people that don't like it more than I talk. Well, I'm not saying I don't like to talk to people that like it. It's always nice to get someone to say, oh, this is the best thing in the world.
Yeah.
But, you know, you're going to have someone who goes, not my jam. And then you're like, well, why? What, you know, sometimes they want to talk to you, sometimes not. You know, you got to kind of figure that out, case by case, I guess you could say, right? But you'll also get a chance to network, and especially when we're trying to do things ourselves, then you build a network of things to be able to do some of the specific or the larger events that we've done. Because we've been able to accomplish things just because of the fact that we know a lot of people that are capable of helping us and they want to help us. So that's been a really unique, and it's been a real cool progression of how we've grown.
Yeah.
We've done it very differently than everyone else, and I'm proud of it.
How can people follow you and follow the Mystic Mountain story online?
Well, we do. So that's one thing that I will have to admit. We are still, this goes back to the grassroots
developing
approach,
it out.
And this is one of the starts of getting our online presence better. We do have our Facebook for the tasting room, which is the Mystic Mountain Distillery Tasting Room. We also have Mystic Mountain Distillery on Facebook, as well as Twitter and Instagram.
Well, thank you for having us. It's been great.
It's been a pleasure to meet you guys. And thank you for coming.
Well, thank you all for joining us for another episode of the Whiskey Culture Podcast, your wide window into the world of whiskey, brought to you by Granddaddy Mims Distillery out of Blairsville, Georgia, making some killer moonshine. Thank you all so much. We'll see you next time. Cheers.